Good evening, everyone, and you're listening to another episode of Deathmatch Russell Podcast. It's Tuesday night, and we're going to be talking to the Spider, pro wrestler Spider Nate Webb from CZW and IWA South and many of places he's been over the years, and we're going to talk about his upcoming debut in Chicago for GCW's Untouchables, and stay tuned. Let's hear what he's got to say and much more. Tune in. Good evening, Nate Webb, and how you doing tonight, man?
Doing well.
Yeah, what's going on with you?
Just waking up, trying to...
Yeah. I know how it is. It's like, I didn't want to wake up for work this morning, but I had to, you know?
Yeah, I'm 12 hours different.
I know. I know that difference in the time zones, you know? I think it's, what, 8 o'clock almost now? Yeah, 8 o'clock here, you know?
Yeah, this is my 8 o'clock in the morning.
Well, good morning.
Right?
I know. But you just got back from Clusterfuck, didn't you? You were just down in New Orleans for GCW's Clusterfuck, right?
I was.
How was that? It was so much fun, I heard.
It was an experience.
Yeah, cool. Yeah, the crowd there was, like, really amped up, and you guys looked like y'all had fun in it, you know?
Are we live now?
We're on the mic. We're talking live.
Oh, okay, I just thought I was calling and there was going to be some kind of intro, so I'm just talking like, whatever.
Yeah.
No, it was definitely an experience. It was definitely an experience. Crowd was hot, and I don't know, that's the first time I'd worked for GCW, and it was pretty awesome.
I know. And now you're going to also be coming to Chicago for Untouchables, I think it's called, you know, for Chicago GCW. I'll be making my way there too, so I can't wait to hang out with you and have a couple beers. You know, this time we're going to party, you know, hang out.
I think the bars stay open a little bit later in Chicago.
Yes.
Like four in the morning, and you're on Eastern time.
Yeah.
So we gain an hour too, so.
Mm-hmm. So we'll all have fun. You know, a couple of us GCW Jersey people are going to make a trip. Five of us are going to make a trip and go to GCW down there and going to have fun and go see some wrestling and then drink some beers with you. How's that?
There we go.
You know, we'll have fun, you know?
That's the bad thing about New Orleans, man. Like,
yeah.
I didn't get out till sometimes, you know, after 3 a.m.
Oh, I'm sure.
But the thing is, the bars don't close. You know, I'd roll into the hotel room about 11 a.m., so it was a little rough, but it was my vacation, so.
Yeah. But it's all worth fun, you know? It's all worth the good and fun, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I can't even remember when the last time I got shit-faced, you know? Like, really got shit-faced, you know? I mean, hell, what, I'm 41 years old, you know? I feel like I'm,
right.
You know, when you get older, like, you get immune to it, you know? You get immune to it.
Oh, yeah. It just, whatever.
Yeah, exactly. But, so anyway, what else you got going on, Nate? Anything else?
Oh, man, I just been working so much. And
yeah.
I decided to take a vacation, and I went down to, and as I was thinking about, like, you know, I wanted to go see a bunch of people I hadn't seen in years.
Yeah.
So I was thinking about taking a vacation and
going
to the East Coast and going to the West Coast and down South and up North, and then just, you know, but then I thought about it. I was like, man, everyone I know is going to be down in
New Orleans.
New Orleans. So I could just
that was
hit everyone up in one swoop.
I know, right? Like everybody was there, so it's like, wow, you know.
Yeah, I got to see a lot of people. It was, you know, it was really cool. I got to see a lot of other shows.
That's what I was going to say. You probably saw some cool shows while you were there too, because a lot of good shows were going on.
Yeah, I got to see a big battle for the first time.
The big battle, the big characters, right? That's funny shit. Somebody was telling me about it. You know, the referee that I had on last night, Chris Volta, was in it. He was one of the characters. You know, from
yeah, I forget to. I don't know. I traveled down there with Prazak, Dave Prazak, and I got to see Shimmer, you know, a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
So you know that was cool. I don't know. It was like I didn't know what to expect in the GCW the. Clusterfuck. Like I was there the night before, and I can't remember the name of that show.
Bloodsport or whatever, right? I think it was Bloodsport. I think it was.
No, it wasn't the GCW show. It was like a midnight show the Thursday night.
Oh, you know, right. Yeah, probably a Progress or something. Probably.
I can't remember what it was, but
yeah,
there was this big, huge place, and I was looking, and they maybe had a couple hundred, you know, and I'm like. Which is, you know, decent crowd, I guess, but I mean, for that place, it looked really small, you know?
Yeah.
Because I actually went up into the stands there because there was no one sitting up there.
Yeah.
And I saw Quackenbush for the first time in years. And Prazak went up there.
Yeah.
And we're talking to him. And then, so the next night was the GCW show, and it was just like, wow.
Yeah.
It was packed.
It was packed. And no, because I remember seeing you going up in the, you went up on commentary booth up there, way up top, you know. You got on the mic. You got on the mic and, you know, hey, you know. People were like, what is he doing way up there, you know?
Yeah, I was half blown up when I finally got into the match because I had to run up 20 flights of stairs.
Yeah, right? Yeah, I saw you running up the bleachers and it's like, wow, here he goes into the crowd like he always does, you know.
But, something to do.
It is. You know what? I was just thinking back, Nate, when the last time I saw you probably was at the King at Guardians of Hardcore. I think that was the last time I saw you, you know? Before. Earlier in the month. Earlier in the month, I think it was.
Or two couple months ago, something like that.
I know. Feels like time flies, right?
Eddie Kingston, yeah, I was wrestling him.
Yes. Yeah, because that front row fan was mocking him or something, you know? That guy that's always there in the front row. Taxi Cab James, I think his name is.
I have no clue who he is.
I know. He's just in the...
I know he got a...
Yeah.
He was yelling one time. I don't know the guy, but...
No.
I was in the back, and then, at a show...
Yeah.
Like, maybe late summer or something last year, and... I heard yelling. Mm-hmm. Hold on, one second.
Go ahead.
Excuse me.
Yep.
I heard yelling. I was in the back in the locker room, and I heard yelling from someone in the crowd. Ian was on the mic.
Yes.
And he said, and he was saying something, and then and then the mic wasn't on anymore, but there was still yelling going on, and I'm like, what the hell's going on?
Yeah.
And I walk out there, and that guy's standing there.
Yeah.
I guess Ian... kicked him out or something. I'm sitting there like, I was like, what's going on? I look at Ian, I see him, I see the look on his face, and he's walking straight towards the guy. He's like, oh, he's going to tear this guy. So I had to grab him and drag him out the curtain. I was like, I didn't know what was going on. I just didn't want anyone get hit.
Right. But it is what
it is. That's all I know. That's all I know about that, dude.
Yeah. I know. That was a fun night, though. Really a fun night. But... you know, GCW's coming. We're going to have more fun that night, you know?
GCW. Yeah, no, I can't say enough about that promotion.
It's
great time. And yeah. I mean, like, they're doing something, you know, special, man. It's, I don't know, the whole Joey Janela spring break, I mean, man, this is the second year.
And I hope, hopefully you make it to the third year, you know, in New Jersey.
Oh, yeah.
New Jersey, that's making its way, you know, for WrestleMania weekend.
Oh, yeah.
That'd be the first time on East Coast, you know. Jersey has a spring break, you know. I'm surprised they don't like shoot down to Asbury Park, New Jersey, for that little, you know what I mean? Because that's like
right?
Joey's area, my part of my neck of the woods, you know.
Right on, man.
You know, the
show. We call it greetings from Asbury Park clusterfuck.
There you go. There you go.
And we can play Bruce Springsteen the whole time the match is going.
Yeah, right. Go hang out at the Stone Pony right there, you know.
There you go.
That's like 5 minutes away from it, you know, the convention hall.
Maybe we can get Bruce Springsteen in the clusterfuck.
Oh, God.
Or at least a member of the E Street Band.
Yeah,
that would be great.
There you go. There you go.
A member of the E Street Band, that'd be great.
That really would be, yeah. Or some, like, local band member, you know?
Right.
No, like a there's a lot of tribute bands down there. They have, like, the Sublime Bands and, you know.
I imagine.
You know, that's, like, big. And they, like, the Eagles, and they have so many crazy, like, Lynyrd Skynyrd bands, and, you know. It's a pretty little punk rock band scene down there, too, you know. I've never been down there. I always hear about it. And then there's that Sayreville place, too. They always cram lots of people in for concerts, you know.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. But anyway, so what do you got? Well, you just said you're getting ready to travel and, you know, May's coming up, you know.
Yeah, I got a couple...
Other gigs.
Couple things coming up. Some I can't say exactly yet, but I think I'm going to be going up to Canada.
Oh, cool.
Just did a few shows with WWE last month, so that was cool.
Mm-hmm.
I got to do that and see a bunch of people I hadn't seen in a long time. So
yeah, everybody had there was a lot of going on, man. It's just crazy.
Yeah, I mean, I mean, that was cool to see. I mean, it was not so much the wrestling part; it's just the production that goes into it, which was amazed me with them.
Did you check out the WrestleMania at all?
No, I didn't go to the WrestleMania. I did the Fastlane. I was at the Fastlane pay-per-view.
Okay.
And then Raw, then SmackDown. They did a three-shot.
Oh, man, so you saw Drake, huh? You probably saw Drake.
No, not at the Fastlane. I did see Drake actually the week before Fastlane.
Oh, cool.
NXT was in Indianapolis, and Hero hit me up.
I went and saw him
at the show, and I got to see Drake and some people I hadn't seen in a while.
That's awesome.
Jeremy Borash was there. I didn't realize he wasn't with TNA anymore. But
yeah, I know, right? Yeah, nobody really knows, pays attention, but no. It's always cool to see Drake when he can, you know? He's an awesome dude.
Definitely. He's doing well, obviously.
I know. He's got a beautiful family, you know? He's got a beautiful kid.
Yeah, he's got another one on the way.
I know, man. You know?
So
can say about him. Nothing. Good
things. It's always good to see people, you know, doing well, especially, you know, he's from Indianapolis, too. So
that's
always cool to see.
I know. You've had so many matches past, you know, in the past, I'm sure, with him, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Tons of matches, you know? But, yeah, so you like how I got a podcast now, Nate? This is cool. Ain't this cool that I this is like booming, dude. I'm just tomorrow night. I'm stoked. I'm gonna have the writer who wrote Dr. David Schultz book on.
Oh yeah,
yeah. The writer, and he's writing Madman Pondo's book. That's cool.
Oh yeah.
That's pretty cool, huh?
Yeah,
and it's kind of wild because I was a kid and I saw David Schultz at the local Ice Palace by me. How like crazy is that? You know, like I was I know. That's the time I saw Bruiser Brody inside a steel cage. You know,
holy crap!
I know, right? Like I had wrestling was big back in the 90s and 80s back here. You know, on the Jersey Shore. You know.
Oh yeah. I mean, it still is.
Yeah, it is. But I guess that NWF took over that federation in, you know, Indiana, or it's in Kentucky, or in Cincinnati, or Ohio area, you know.
What is it?
NWF, Northern Wrestling Superstars, I think it's called. I forget.
Yeah.
James Storm's a part of it, too, I heard.
Oh, okay.
You know, he's one of the old people that's always there, you know.
Yeah.
And Larry D, too, I think. Larry D. Legendary Larry D, or I forget his name. I don't know.
Oh, yeah. He does some IWA shows.
Yeah.
He wrestled for Ohio Valley for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Or I don't know if he still does.
No.
Maybe he still does. I don't know if he does.
There's so many wrestlers. That, I know. It's like, where'd they go, you know? But
that's wrestling. You can go anywhere you want.
I know. So who trained you, actually, Nate?
I had a lot of different
trainers.
Influences. Yeah. I started out with WCWO.
Yeah.
Which is a local promotion here in Indianapolis.
Yeah.
And I did that for about a year and a half, 2 years before I went out and started, you know, getting around more people because, you know, you can only learn so much at one organization. So, you know, I got to, you know, that's why I, you know, met up with, you know, Pondo and them, and I got down to IWA. And then,
CZW, you know, I jumped it to, then he went to CZW, tore it up there for so many years, you know?
Yeah. But, you know, just, I got to, you know, I luckily I came up around good, you know, good people, you know, like, cause when I started going to IWA is, you know, when, you know, Cabana and Punk and Ace and Prazak and everyone were coming down. And then, of course, Hero was there and Ian was bringing in people, you know, like Jerry Lynn and, you know, Tracy Smothers and,
all
and
the stuff old, like all the old Chris, people that we know. Yeah.
Yeah. Chris Candido. So, I mean, it was, you know, it was a good learning, you know, experience.
You I'll tell you what, I'm still friends with Johnny Candido, Chris's brother. He's doing all right, you know.
Oh, right on.
Keep in contact with the family, you know. At least one person I know, and, you know, he's a really cool dude. He used to be a wrestler, too, you know. But then he stopped and got married, you know.
That's what happens.
I know, but he did a cool documentary, actually, about his brother. It was really cool. I'll have to find that for you.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, he did a really cool, like, right in Spring Lake, you know, right in his house. It was cool, you know.
Right on.
Showing me his rec room, showing his room that he grew up in, you know, like Chris's room and stuff. It's like a little dungeon, you know, like a wrestling art gallery. It was really cool, you know.
Yeah. Oh, what I was saying earlier, though, that WWE thing, the thing that was most amazing to me is just the production that goes into it.
Isn't it amazing? It blows your mind, like what they do with lasers.
No, it's like they're setting up for the Oscars every night.
I know.
It just, I couldn't even comprehend it. Like, I'm just like, wow. There's someone for everything. I mean, like, and there's probably 10 people for every one thing.
It is. It's a big production. Could you imagine, like, just being like a helper and set up a chair? You'd be there for hours.
Dude, I was watching them. I was like, man, like they'd come in like an army setting up, you know, floor chairs and like they had, you know, different groups. And I'm just like, what the hell?
It's like a concert, like a mega concert. You know what I mean? Like the stage setting is unbelievable, you know?
Of course they do it every week. So I guess
they're so used to it. They're so used to it. Like how we, you know, like if we're at a show, we have to help set up the rings sometimes or, you know what I mean? Set up the chairs. Yeah. It doesn't matter. You know, I always help Brett when I can, you know, I always say, hey, I'll help.
You know, all their caterers and the doctors and the seamstress. Man, they had like 10 sewing machines going all the time back there. I was like, wow.
This is cool. Yeah, like, how come I don't get this shit?
No, I just like everyone always talks about their experience, you know, wrestling the crowd and everything. And I'm just like, I'm watching backstage. I'm like, this is amazing.
Yeah, the production behind everything is so, it's really amazing how they get it all set up and ready to go. And the pyros and the, you know, the screens and the, you know, all the
hanging lights. And then like, I can't even put it in words. Like I'm just sitting there watching it for like 3 days straight going, wow.
Yeah, I know.
I try to watch something different every day that was going on back there. And I'm like, look at this.
I know a couple of my friends do like the electric work once in a while for them, you know?
Like, oh, right on.
I know. It's like, wow. When they go to the Giant Stadium or the, you know, the MetLife Stadium, you know?
Yeah.
It's like, wow, look at this shit. Give them credit for doing that shit, you know?
So they're having it, the WrestleMania next year at the...
Yeah, MetLife Stadium.
Isn't that going to be kind of cold?
I don't know, in April? I don't know.
Oh, man, it was snowing yesterday here in Indianapolis.
Was it? Shit, there's no snow. No, I'm sick of that weather. I'm sick of that crap. Come on, spring, summertime, you know?
Yeah.
No, but I don't know. Wait a minute. I don't know if they have the dome over that or not. No, that's the Prudential Center. They have that. I'm thinking that, you know. Yeah, when they knock down the Giant Stadium, you know. It's like, MetLife Stadium's a new one, you know.
Right.
You know, I never, I think I actually went to the Giant Stadium one year and I saw my neighbor had tickets for the Rolling Stones, and I went to a Rolling Stones concert. I was like, this is freaking awesome, you know, to see Rolling Stones on concert, the stage coming out, you know, like the production's crazy, you know?
I had a ticket for Rolling Stones a few years back. They were in Indianapolis on 4th of July, and they played at the Indianapolis Motor Speedway.
Yeah.
So.
But I'll never forget taking my dad to GCW. We went to my local baseball stadium, right? Had a little, one of those little cheap, you know, theaters and, like, you know, wrestling shows, fairs and music fest was going on. So I took my dad. We saw Poison. We saw Alice Cooper, excuse me.
I just saw Alice Cooper last summer.
Did you?
Yep.
Yeah, that was so cool to see. Like, I was blown away.
When I was with the Midgets, we actually got to open at this, it was like a music festival, and we got to open for Alice Cooper. It was a Black Label Society, Alex Cooper, and Rob Zombie.
Oh, cool. Cool. I think Blue Oyster Cult opened up for him, you know.
Oh.
Isn't that cool? I know. But, my dad was like, this is cool. Like, you know, Brett hooked us up with, like, tickets, you know what I mean? Cheaper tickets. I was like, damn, we got in for, it was raining and shit, too, you know? So, like, people were fading out, you know what I mean?
I wonder if Blue Oyster Cult works the angle from, Saturday Night Live with the cowbell.
Oh yeah, the cowbell.
I wonder if I was them, I would totally do that every time I got ready to play that song.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. That's so funny. But yeah, I remember I saw, and then GCW came around again, and it was like in the summertime. I saw like Stone Temple Pilots before the guy died. Like, you know.
Oh yeah, Scott Weiland.
Yeah.
Yep. I got to see, was it last year?
Mm-hmm.
I went and saw Soundgarden here in Indianapolis.
Yeah.
And it was on a Wednesday. And I remember the next Wednesday, they were in Detroit. And that's when he passed away. So I literally got to see him. And that was the first time. I had tickets to like a Chris Cornell concert years ago. But like for some reason, it got canceled or something.
Right.
And so it took like another 10 years for, you know, Sound, and I was like, okay, I'm going to Soundgarden. And
then
he passed away a week later, and I'm like, man, that sucks.
I know, it's like, wow, we saw these guys play, and shit, you know, they're gone.
Oh, man, they're like, you wonder what's up with people, you know, you know, they're not happy or whatever, but I mean, like,
the news? Did you see who else just died? I think Huey Lewis just died.
What?
Huey Lewis just died. Yeah.
Dude,
I know, right?
I just saw him last year too.
Really?
Are you serious?
There was something on the news about him dying.
Okay, now
you're gonna have to look. Go ahead and look.
Because what's his name? Ermy, the drill sergeant,
I know, and Harry
just passed away. Harry Anderson just passed away.
I know, right?
And then we were talking. Some song came on, and someone was talking about Annette Funicello. I was like, "Is she dead?" She's like, "I think she is." And she passed away in 2013.
Yeah.
And then he goes, "Well, friend, like a guy that owns a bar." He goes, "How old's what's his name?" Frankie Avalon or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, oh, let me look it up. And he died like 2 days ago. Mm-hmm. And I didn't even know.
No, excuse me. Oh, no, he did not die. He's got a hearing problem.
Jesus Christ.
All right, he's not dead. My bad. Okay. Okay.
Yeah, Huey Lewis doesn't die.
He'll never die. No, I thought he did. Hearing loss. Yeah, due to hearing loss, it's saying tour canceled.
Tour canceled?
Tour canceled. I guess he's doing a cancellation tour. I don't know. When was this? Chicago 18 tour canceled. I don't know. This is like an upcoming show. Let me see here. I'm curious. Huh.
I didn't hear. Like Brian Johnson from AC/DC.
Yeah. But I can't believe like those people die. Like they die just like it's like I grew up watching like you know watching that on TV. The Night Court. Come on, you know.
Right. I just binge watched all 11 seasons of Cheers on Netflix.
Yeah. I was like, this is crazy.
Right.
And then the other guy died. I used to love him. You know, we all love those characters. It's amazing who dies these days.
Yeah.
No, it just says that he was in a he had he. Lo- What the hell? Scheduled to perform August. Okay. Oh, So August 4th, maybe this is like this year, he's canceling because he has his hearing problem. Oh, well.
Well, maybe they can fix it. Because he was real. I tell you what, as I said, I saw him last year around this time, maybe like last May or whatever. Mm-hmm. But he was really good.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
He was really good. It was awesome.
Yeah. I'll have to play that after I play your song later.
Right? Power level. One time, it was my birthday years ago, and we were in Nashville for the TNA pay-per-view or whatever. Yeah. And after the show, everyone went out. Right. We all went downtown Nashville and stuff, you know, everyone. And Punk was there, and he goes, because it's your birthday, I'll do this. And he got on stage. There was this big bar. I think it was called what was it called? Hurricanes or something like that. Yeah. And everyone was there, but in the back there was this karaoke.
Oh, shit.
And it was like a separate karaoke bar. And Punk got up there and sang Power of Love.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. That's funny. Punk, he had some crazy days. I miss him, you know?
he sang Power of Love. And then, I don't know, Jeff Jarrett kept wanting me to sing... What he kept saying goes, you know that song, it goes boom and a boom. He just kept saying boom and emphasizing boom. And I'm like, you know, here comes the boom.
Yeah.
He goes, yeah. Like, I had no clue what he was talking about. Me and Hero were sitting there looking at each other like, what?
You know what's so cool, Nate? One year at New Year's, my sister had a New Year's party. This guy and his son come out, right? Come over to the house, right? And we don't know who he is. And we go into the kitchen. His son wants some cherries. Bing cherries. It was CC DeVille of Poison.
He just was randomly came by the house?
Yeah. I'm like, this is badass. I'm hanging out with CC DeVille, you know? How random is that? And he had his jacket on with a little cherry on it, you know, from Warren, you know? I'm like, this is pretty badass. I know. Cool.
From where?
Poison, excuse me.
Oh, okay. I was like...
Yeah, no. No, Poison with that, I think it had the bomb on the t-shirt. It had a little bomb logo, the bomb, you know? But it was really cool to, you know, to have my picture hanging out with him on New Year's, you know what I mean? He was sober. It was kind of weird. Like, it was really...
Yeah, I think he's sober now.
Yeah.
I think a lot of those guys are sober or they're going to be dead.
Yeah, so that's my little fame, you know? Like, my little Rock of Fame hanging out with him. My sister's friends knew him or something, you know.
Right on.
So, you know, but that's so cool to know, you know. So someone wanted cherry, and I was like, wait a minute, cherry pie? I started saying, like, I said, yeah, well, let's have some cherry pie. And then, you know, CC's like, that's my song, man, you know. No shit. Yeah. You know? I'm like, wow.
That's one thing cool about wrestling is it gives you other opportunities to, like, meet. Like people that you never would normally meet, like, you know, like for instance, like I listened to Smashing Pumpkins, you know,
right
back in high school. I got to go, a couple years ago, I got to go backstage when they were in town and sit and talk to Billy Corgan for, you know, a couple hours before the show.
Yeah.
To talk about wrestling. And it was just weird. It's, you know, surreal. You know, he's big into wrestling, and I'm like, he owns NWA now, but...
I know, he's getting that going, I think, you heard, you know?
Yeah, so, I mean, it's just weird how, you know, wrestling takes you weird places.
Yeah, right, and WWE inducts a Hall of Fame Kid Rock this year, you know? I'm like, right? Why did he really do nothing, you know?
It's but like, he's Kid Rock. He's just, I don't know, I guess he's had some musical connection. Credits.
Probably.
Some of the... In the past years or whatever.
Yeah. I'm surprised
you didn't. And I walked out, I was like backstage at SmackDown here in Indy, and I walked out. Yeah. It was weird. And I didn't know what was going on, but I walked down the hall and I got to the corner, and there standing was the whole cast from Super Troopers in full gear.
Oh, no shit.
And they were all in full gimmick, and I'm just like, you know, I'm just like, what the hell's going on?
Yeah.
Like, I had no clue why they were shooting something, apparently, but, yeah, like, promo, you know, it's surprising. Yeah. Like, why are Super Troopers here?
That's so cool though, you know? You never know what goes on, you know, in a show or anything, you know? They always do some weird shit.
Well, I understand if they were, you know, like maybe a little bit understand more if they were just the actors, but no, they were the actors at full gimmick. I mean, they were completely dressed up.
That's awesome. Yeah.
I'm just like, what the fuck?
Yeah, you're like, mind if I ask what's going on, you know? Right? Let me see what's going on here. Can I be in it? What the hell? You know?
Right.
You never know.
Yeah, no, I did get to see Jason Ayers though. He's from Indiana. Mm-hmm. He's doing very well with them.
That's cool.
Of course, it's cool to see him on the, you know, mm-hmm. rest pay per view.
Yeah. I know this pay per view was crazy this year. You know, did you watch it at all after? Like, did you watch the pay per view after at all?
Which one?
WrestleMania.
I saw little clips. Yeah, like I saw Drake in there, and then I saw Jason in there. During the Fastlane pay per view, I saw it backstage. There's like a viewing area that you can just sit there and watch it.
Yeah, cool. That's awesome. I know that's pretty cool how you guys have like the backstage. Like you can really see what's the cool video coming from the footage. You know of the show. Yeah.
And you know, as I said, it's really cool to watch it there because, like as I said, like I never Jimmy would tell me about like man, it's crazy back there, and I never understood how crazy. I was like, oh, it can't be that crazy until I like actually saw it, and I'm like, it's like, I was back there years and years ago, like at old Joe Louis Arena,
right?
When Zach Gallen was with him, but I mean, like it's changed.
It's changed. Like, I know, so man. Digital media is so unbelievable. You know, technology is to the next level of it beyond, you know. I mean, hell, they got drones that fly around, droids, and, you know, all those crazy little devices fly around, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I remember they had that for TOD. That was badass, you know. The Vice TV came in, and they had those drones flying around, you know, for TOD.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, that was a cool document. I showed that to my friend just recently.
But yeah, no, I'm looking forward to the GCW thing coming up. Yeah, what was it? It's May 12th
May 12th, yeah, May 12th or May 11th too. You know,
I think they got Janela's on the show.
Everybody,
Gage,
I know,
man,
Extremo, Cyclope, you know,
yeah,
the fucking DDT, you guys. Hell, we saw them, and shit, it's like we got to see them. We see them all the time, though. You know, it's amazing.
Yeah. But so, I know you're from the area. What's going on with CZW? I heard that I see people like getting shitty about stuff.
I have no clue, Nate. You know, I really, you know how I am. I'm just a fan. I enjoy whatever goes on. You know, I just listen. I laugh at them. You know, I don't care.
All right.
You know, it's just bullshit. I think Joey left for his own good. You know, he don't care.
No.
He don't care. You know.
Well, I saw fans getting shitty about something or other. I didn't know what was going on.
No, like, and then they had some stupid fucking. There was some promotion coming in, like some marks came in chanting, "CZW's unfair," you know, unfair. This stupid little marks came in, wrestling guys that don't know what they're doing, you know. It was like stupid. DJ's like, really? Kicked him out, you know. We're like, get the fuck out, you know.
Oh yeah. Yeah. Were you there?
Yeah, I was there. I went to the best of the best. It was really good. I enjoyed it. It was great to see Rich Swann again, you know?
Oh, yeah.
He made his appearance, you know? So he deserved to be in the best of the best, you know? Why not? He's Rich Swann. You know, DJ said, he said, let me in, you know? So, okay. There you go.
Cool.
But Matt Riddle was there, and, you know, pretty awesome to see him in action, like always. You know, he's tearing it up no matter where he goes, you know? He's a pretty good, you know, cool dude, you know, wrestler. But David Starr deserved it, and, you know, because he's been there for a long time, you know.
Right on.
Did you get to watch the David Starr versus Quack?
I did not. It was literally the match before ours.
Oh, man.
So I did not. But the next day, there's a picture on my Twitter.
Yeah.
He was on a show the next day or something before, and He left his ring jacket backstage, yeah. So right. Of course I put it on and tweeted a picture of it.
Oh, nice, nice.
But nice. He came back and got his jacket.
yeah. No, that was so cool to see. See Quack back in the ring and wrestle. Like, you know, it's amazing to see him.
He hasn't lost a step, has he?
He's never has. He's got that. He's knowledgeable, man. He has his own podcast. He tells you behind the scenes. You know, it's like the ins and outs.
Unfortunately, I was sleeping due to prior engagements the night before in Bourbon Street. But I heard some people went to his. He had a seminar down there. And,
oh, cool.
Yeah. I kind of wanted to go see that, but
I want to stay. I got one of these days, Nate. I'm just going to go as a, I'm going to check out a seminar. I'd like to. I hear so much cool things about them, you know.
Yeah, I'm just sitting talking to him. You know, it's very interesting to talk to.
Mm-hmm. You learn a lot at a seminar, you know.
But yeah,
that's what I want to do is just check out a seminar, local seminar when it comes around or something, you know.
Yeah.
Learn more about the business, you know.
I think he runs them.
Yeah,
or he does something there at the Wrestle Factory or something.
Yeah, with Rory Gulak.
Rory,
the amazing. That was great when he came out with his no fear, no the CZW sign.
No clusterfucks.
Yes. Yes. Everybody's, is this like Drew Gulak coming out? No. You know.
Oh yeah, they lost their shit.
Mm-hmm. They did. Dude, what did you think of that Quebecer guy? Holy did you see that, Matt? Did you see that big dude and that German guy? I forget their name.
I didn't get to catch that. I didn't get to see it, like, really any of the matches because there was not really there wasn't a viewing station back there, but
you probably had see pictures and I know. It's like, wow. You probably heard about it. It was good. It was really.
And I saw things on Twitter. I don't know. It's like, is there a place where there's a bunch like pictures from the shows or like a site or something? I don't know.
Chris Grosso has them. Chris has them. Maybe.
Okay. You have to email or message me a link or something because I haven't seen. I've seen like a few GIFs here and there.
From Joe, that guy Joe that does the GIFing. Yeah. But yeah, I really didn't see anything. You know. But Twitter always shows stuff, you know?
Yeah.
But no, those dudes were big. They were pretty going at it, chop for chop, you know?
So right.
Those chops are killer, you know? But a lot of them... But the clusterfuck was more fun, though. I enjoyed that. That was more fun to watch on, you know, the pay-per-view. I was watched it the night after, you know?
Right.
Because I just fucking lost my credit card. I'm like, oh, shit. Somebody hacked my card, you know?
I think all the commentators were drunk during that match.
Yeah. I know, I lost my credit card. I was like, fuck, I can't get my pay-per-view tonight. Shit, I can't get this. I couldn't order it. I was so pissed off. So I had friends tweeting me, you know? What's going on? You know, I'm curious, you know?
Right on.
I could have gone to a friend's house and watched it, but I was like, nah, you don't want to... I want to watch WrestleMania soon, Dad, with my old band, you know?
Right.
So we did that. I didn't watch the whole 24 hours or whatever, how long that 3 hours.
Yeah, we actually left that morning. I was passing the arena or the stadium.
Yeah.
Like in the afternoon right before WrestleMania started. I'm like, all right, well, let's get out of town.
Yeah. You know. I was going to go down to New Orleans, but it was like, you know what? It's going to be so crowded this year. It's going to be so much people, you know?
It was worth it, man. It was cool to see.
But this year, I'll definitely do the WrestleMania, and I'll definitely go next year, you know? When it's here.
Yeah, right.
Right in my backyard. I don't have to travel that far, you know?
Yeah, there you go.
I know. Crashing on my friends' couches or whatever. But, all right, Nate. Want to let you go?
Right on.
You have a good night, and you want to plug anything? Just plug up GCW, right? That's it?
Yeah, GCW.
GCW.
And wrestling.
And all that crap.
Huey Lewis.
Huey Lewis in the news.
Right?
All right, Nate. Thank you for being on, man. You have a good night.
Thank you too, man.
All right, bye-bye.
Bye.
Wow, that was cool. We had talked with Nate Webb tonight We talked to Nate Webb tonight, and he's getting ready. He was just in the clusterfuck head. If you fans didn't hear about the clusterfuck, GCW Spring Break 2 in New Orleans, it was something else. It really was wild. If you never gone there before, you know, or you never, I'm sure you've seen it on the pay-per-view, you rent it on Powerbomb TV or the WWN link that they had. It was great. Highly recommend checking it out. And, you know, like we said before, we're going to be, Nate Webb's going to be heading to Chicago May 12th for GCW Presents Untouchables. Untouchables in Chicago. So, fans, make sure if you're in the area, check it out, man. It's going to be a lot going on there. May 11th, May 11th is going to be on a Friday night. We're going to be seeing Freelance Wrestling takes on GCW, and that's going to be something to check out, fans. So if you're in the Chicago area, come on out and check out GCW versus Freelance Underground. It's going to be crazy. And then the next night is the GCW main show. It's going to be awesome. We can't wait. We're all excited. We're just counting down the days and much more, you know. And gonna do my plugs now. I want to shout out, check it out tomorrow night, fans. I'm gonna be talking to, no, actually, what is it? Tomorrow's Wednesday night. I'll be on the Everett Lee show with Everett Lee and his co-host Chris Carnage, and also it's called Pop City Network. I'm a part of their team too, so check it out. Pop City Network. I mean, Podcast City Network, and much more. Check it out. All my interviews are updated right up to their site, and you can catch me on their show tomorrow night at 9:05 p.m. And then on Thursday night, I'm going to be plugging right now. I guess on Thursday night, I'm going to have the guest, the co-writer, the writer for the Dr. Schultz, David Schultz, pro wrestling book, John Corsif, on the line. And he's also going to be, we're going to talk about his upcoming book he's doing for Madman Pondo, and much more. And then on Friday night, I'm going to have Big Donnie on the line. That's right. Big Donnie's going to be joining me, the pro wrestler, Big Donnie. So stay tuned, fans. That's going to be fun. And it's going to be fun talking with him. But as always, you know, I'll plug it again. You know, keep on plugging it and plugging it. And, also, my friend Rob Nelson of Wrestle Popcast, alongside Deathmatch Russell Podcast, we're linked up with the Pod City Network. So check it out, podcitynetwork.com, and on Facebook. I'll link it up later for you guys to check out. And then, as always, you can always find your Deathmatch Russell podcasts on Facebook at David C. Russell, on Twitter at DJ Dave NJ32, and on my website for your current and past interviews, highlight reels, promos, merchandise, event info, and much more. You can check out Deathmatch Russell podcast.com for all your interviews. And much, much more. So, fans, have a great evening. Now, check me out tomorrow on the Everett Lee Show at 9:05 p.m. Good night, everyone. And tune in, as always.
It's a DeLorean. Hey, guys, it's that $5 show, man.
Okay, Huey, I think we're all set for you.
Really? Oh. Okay, this is it. We're back. I told you we'd be back, right?
No,
that's not a stereo. It's what it is. Now I know it's been a few years. I know it's been a few years. But Hollywood finally caught. That's it. Your favorite group is in the movie business.
What's going on in there?
Music.
What kind of music?
Dancing. Rock and roll. Huey?
This is the place.
I've got to get in there.
You're expecting
me. Come on, let's go.
Look around on my machine. Don't touch anything. I'll be right back.
And I know it's a good song. And, I mean, it's got to be a good movie. They even got jackets. Gonzo, show me the jacket. Check this out. For real. Moment you've been waiting for.
New song.
From the big smash hit movie, our latest single, The Power of Love.